We continue our lockdown devotions now with Reverend Atulangi, Assistant National Superintendent Pastoral Care with the Wesleyan Methodist Church of New Zealand, Vinakavaka Level. And thank you as always for your time, Tala Tala.
Tala Level, thanks, Brian. Malolele, Tala Falava, Kiorana, Tatoka Totoa, Falavale Yatu. And greetings to all your wonderful listeners, Brian, this wonderful afternoon. And allow me just to share with you a devotional message, recapping on most of the things that I've shared with you during this week, ladies and gentlemen. I want to title this short message this afternoon that we are called and commissioned by God to be witnesses of the gospel. And Acts chapter 1 verse 8, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. Allow me just to break this down. At such a time as this that we live in, there's a lot of negativity. There's a lot of disruption. There's a lot of ugly kinds of information that is going around. There's a lot of trouble, there's a lot of depression, there's a lot of stuff happening, ladies and gentlemen. So as Christians, what is our calling? What is our responsibility? And I will try and recap on some of the things that I've been sharing with you this week, just to help us as believers, as Christians. What a wonderful opportunity that you and I have at such a time as this, to be witnesses of the gospel, witnesses of the truth of God in accordance to his way, not our way. We are not called by God to be troublemakers, ladies and gentlemen. As Christians, let me remind us again, we are called to be peacemakers. There's a ministry of reconciliation. Remember, Jesus said in Matthew chapter 5, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. Jesus didn't say pastors, Jesus didn't say Christians. He said, if it is your desire to see the good in others, if it is your desire to see people living together in harmony, that is a powerful witness. Number one, witness is personal. And Revelation chapter 12, verse 11, ladies and gentlemen, at such a time as this, I pray that you will be a witness. It is personal. Also, and Revelation says, they triumphed over him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. They did not love their lives so much as to shrink from death. I pray that you as an individual, that you will allow God to use your life to be a witness of the gospel, a witness of Jesus Christ, that Christ will manifest in you. Remember, I asked the question in the last couple of days as I was sharing with you. Jesus said, love your neighbor, love your God with all your heart, mind, and soul, and strength, but love your neighbor. How can we love our neighbors? Neighbors that are going through difficult times at such a time as this. And I pray that you will allow God to use your life. Second, witness is primarily about the resurrection. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, Paul says in verse 17, if Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile. You are still in your sins. Then those also who have fallen asleep in Christ are lost. If only for this life, we have hope in Christ. We are all of people most to be pitied. But Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. Second point, ladies and gentlemen, because Jesus is alive. I love what Paul says. For me, life as it defines life is to know Christ and the power of his resurrection. How can the world, how can the whole of New Zealand know of the truth of the resurrection? It comes back to your witness, that you allow God to use your life in your conduct, in your behavior, in your language, that others, those that are seeking, those that are lost, those that do not know Christ will come to know Christ and make him known. Number three, ladies and gentlemen, witness is Christ-centered. John 13:35, by this everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. I constantly remind my church folks that I pastor the local church. Church, if we cannot connect and translate the pulpit and what has been said every Sunday, the Bible study, to the way we live our lives as a church, we might as well forget about church and close church. The world is dying and looking for a safe place. And I pray that as Christians, as believers, that we, the living church, that we be that go-to person, that those that are struggling, that those are needing help in such a time as this, that you will be the Christian, the witness of the gospel, that they will come around, that they will ring, that they will call upon and say, brother, I see the way you live your life and the way you witness the gospel. There's something different. There's something attractive. There's something appealing about you. Man, I would love to come and have a chat with you. Witness is Christ-centered. It's about Jesus Christ, ladies and gentlemen. And that is the gospel. That is the good news. The good news is about the personhood of Jesus Christ that the Bible talks about. Number four, witness is accompanied by the witness of the Spirit. Galatians chapter 5 says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such thing, there is no law. Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. Since we live by the Spirit, let us keep in step with the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, provoking, and envying each other. Let me say that. Let's stop causing trouble. Let's stop being a troublemaker. But let's be a witness of the gospel. The Bible says, for the gospel is the power of salvation to all mankind. Wow. What an opportunity. What a privilege for you and I to be a witness of the gospel. And allow the Holy Spirit to manifest in our lives. And last point that I want to share with us this afternoon, the goal of witnessing is the salvation of others, not just the spreading, the dissemination of the gospel for information, but it is the salvation of others. Brothers and sisters, Jesus came as the greatest gift of all, who gave his life for you and I, for the whole world, that the whole world may come to know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. On this Friday afternoon, I pray with all the news, with all that is happening, and the lockdown at home, I pray that you will allow God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, that you will give God your life, surrender your life, and allow the Holy Spirit to transform you and the Word of God to take precedence in your life. I close with 1 Timothy chapter 2, and I shared this with you in the last couple of days. I urge that, first of all, that petition, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgiving be made for all people, for kings and all those in authority, that we may live peaceful and quiet lives in all godliness and holiness. This is good and pleases God our Savior, who wants all people to be saved and to come to a knowledge of the truth. For there is one God and one mediator between God and mankind, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself as a ransom for all people. This has now been witnessed to at the proper time. And for this purpose, I was appointed a herald and an apostle. I'm telling the truth. I'm not lying. And a true and faithful teacher of the Gentiles. Therefore, I want the men everywhere to pray, lifting up holy hands without anger or disputing. I also want the women to dress modestly. I close with that. Let's be witnesses of the gospel. There are men and women that are struggling right now. They are close to you. They're probably your neighbors, work colleagues. And I pray that as Christians, we don't need to stir trouble again. Let the truth of God manifest in us. I believe the world is dying to come to know of the truth of who Jesus is. Close with a story. There was a man who was looking for a church or a place of fellowship. So he went to the Pentecostals, Brian, fellowship with them, enjoyed the singing, the praise the Lord. They were so hyped up that some of them were just about to touch the ceiling and they're praising. Wow, wonderful. He came out, went to the Methodist church. And he said, wow, the Methodists are amazing. The choir, they can sing. He went to the Catholic church, came out and said, wow, no one beats the Catholic when it comes to Missa. They are very good at it. So he went to a few other churches. At the end of his searching and looking for a place of fellowship, and this is what he said. Well, I don't really care how good you praise God, and even you're so hyped up that you're just about to touch the ceiling. I don't care how good the choir sings. I don't care how good you read the Bible. And this is what he said. But what I care most, when all this is finished, when you land, when the prayer has come to an end, the reading of the word has come to an end, the preaching has come to an end, what I care most is when you land and how straight you walk. Ladies and gentlemen, I pray that God is looking for someone to stand in the gap and pray. God is looking at you, that you be willing and be open to allow the Lord to use you at such a time as this to be a witness of the gospel, that people may come to know of the salvation that is found in Christ, the power of the gospel be manifested, the truth of Christ be expressed in the way you conduct yourselves. Lord, I pray that you bless each and every person that is listening and tuning in on this Friday afternoon. Pray that God, that you help us as Christians, that we are called to be witnesses of the gospel. Lord, you remind us always and constantly in your word, the world will only come to know of the truth of the gospel when we truly love one another. I pray that God, that at such a time as this, that we will be helpful and be grateful, that we will be, Lord, be supportive of one another, that we'll show compassion, that Christ will manifest in the way we live our lives today. There is a dying world. There are people that are very much in need of a safe place. And I pray that may our lives and our churches be a safe place where people can come to fellowship with you. Thank you for Brian. May you continue to give him God wisdom and knowledge as he continues to share with us and communicate with us on this wonderful Friday afternoon. We give you honor and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Reverend Atu Lange, Assistant National Superintendent, Pastoral Care with the Wesleyan Methodist Church of New Zealand. Vinagavaga level, tala tala. So blessed this week. Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care.
God bless. God bless.